Now I know this model looks rather daunting to paint, however today I'm going to show you how to paint the Necron Silent King easy peasy Catan squeezy. And it's coming right up.
Necrons!
Nick speaking and welcome to this video. Right, today we are going to paint the Necron Silent King. I'm going to paint this in my Dynasty colours, however you can easily adapt what I do here for any dynasty that you like. So first of all, we've got all of these pieces here, so let me explain what's going on. Basically, I have magnetized my Silent King. The base, the middle section and the top section are pinned and magnetized. Then I've got the King himself and his two bodyguards, which are separate and magnetized onto the throne. And then I've got the steps, the little stand which the king is on, and of course the Catan separate, which I'm going to paint sub-assembly and glue them on afterwards. Right, let's get on with painting it. Okay, so here we are. We're using Iron Breaker first. I've got some on my wet palette. I'm then going to take a large dry brush. I'm going to put some onto that dry brush. Then I'm going to take it off using the cloth and then the tissue, so we hardly have any paint on the brush whatsoever. We are then going to lightly dry brush all over the miniature. Now this big dry brush is great for the bigger areas, but I'm going to struggle to get into some of the smaller areas. So later, once I've done all of this with the big brush, I'm going to go in with the small brush as well. Now this is just the first coat, but what we're looking for is to build up the metal colour so we have a worn metal look. We do have the option, if we want to, rather than dry brushing, to just go in and paint silver all over the miniature and then use a wash and then maybe highlight it afterwards. However, I find this technique not only looks good, but it's also very easy to do. So it's how I paint all of my Necrons. And you can see me here going in with the smaller brush, just into the little gaps and areas that the big brush missed. And I do this all over the miniature. Okay, so next we are going to go in with Lead Belcher. We're basically going to repeat what we did with the Iron Breaker, but with this colour. We're going to gently dry brush all over the silver that we've already done, just building up the colour. We still want a bit of a mottled look, but after this coat, it is going to look like worn metal. It's going to look very cool. Now, if you want to find out more about dry brushing techniques and also about how I made my wet palette, then I have tutorial videos on both of those and a lot more other painting techniques, all linked in the description below. So check them out once you've watched this video if you want to learn more. Okay, so with the silver done, we are going to go in and paint the black stone. Now, I'm going to paint the black stone exactly the same as I did for my monolith, just to keep all things the same within the army. First of all, I'm going to base coat everything that I want in blackstone with black, just basically tidying up some of that dry brushing, which can be a bit messy. So I've got some watered down black paint in my wet palette, and I'm just going to go over all of those sections that are supposed to be blackstone with this black paint. Okay, so next up is Incubi Darkness. Again, I'm going to put some of this on my wet palette and just water it down just very slightly. Now you'll notice that I left the two little circles on either side of that central orb a metal colour. I just felt that they weren't blackstone material, so I didn't want to paint them in blackstone. Okay, so we are going to basically just go over all of that black area with this Incubi Darkness. We're going to build the colour up with a couple of coats to give us a nice even finish. And of course, don't forget to paint the edges, as I'm doing here, around the blackstone itself. Okay, so next we are going to use the Coelia Green Shade. We are going to shade all of the green areas that we've just painted. I'm just going to evenly spread this paint out. You need to work quite fast with this shade. You don't want any areas to dry before you finish painting a whole segment. So just paint this all over the green, and then we're going to let it thoroughly dry. I would suggest leaving it for around 30 minutes. Okay, so once that is dry, we are going to go back in with the Incubi Darkness and we're going to dry brush back over this black stone material. The idea is to bring up the colour of Incubi Darkness, but also leaving those recesses with the shade in, so we get a nice light dark contrast. Okay, next we are going to use Calibite Green. We're going to put this into our wet palette. We're not going to add water. We don't add water to the paint when we're dry brushing. So we are then going to get this paint, put it onto our brush, dry brush it off so there's hardly any paint at all on the brush. Then we're going to gently dry brush over the green which we've just dry brushed. Now, I do this very carefully to build up the colour, so don't go too harsh at first, just gradually build it up, nice and light layers. I actually go over all of the green, the whole areas. You could, if you wanted to, limit this to certain areas, but I feel at this stage it's best to go all over because there's a lot of cracks and little crevices in this piece. Now, when it comes to going around the middle orb, you can see me here working out what I'm going to do. I decided to go in a circle, so I just very gently went in a circle around the orb just to build up that highlight. As I said, there's not much paint on the brush, so it's not too harsh, just gently build up the colour. And I do this all over the blackstone areas, including the blackstone on the top of the throne. Okay, next it's Sybarite Green and we again are going to put some of this onto our wet palette and we're going to do some more dry brushing. Now this is a very gentle dry brush. Actually, if you look at me doing it, I hardly put any paint on. I think I only put one piece of paint at the beginning and I pretty much paint the whole of the piece. Like I said, it's best to have not much paint and just build up the layers. So again, I just gently dry brush this piece, trying to hit the little sticky out edges of all the cracks and crevices, and what I tend to do is dry brush up and down so that the light, sort of imagining the light coming from the top downwards, so that's how I try to imagine it. However, I still go in a circular motion around the orb just to hit all of those circular edges. And of course, I do this all over the blackstone pieces. And there it is, all finished. I've tried to give this blackstone of mine more of an older look than maybe the box art is. The box art is quite bright. I want mine to be a little bit more darker and subdued, as if it's really, really old. Okay, so that's most of the dry brushing out of the way. I am going to be doing some more dry brushing on the Silent King, but that will come later. First though, I'm going to go in and I'm going to paint all of the orbs which are on this model. Now this is where you can change the colour depending on the dynasty that you're taking. You could go for blue or maybe red, yellow, orange, whatever colour you want. Now I'm looking at the stairs here. There are some orbs on the stairs, but I don't 100% know if I'm going to paint the orbs there. And of course there are orbs around the Catan there. Indeed, there's the lightning effects as well, which I'm going to paint. I'm not 100% sure how I'm going to paint the actual Catan yet, to be honest. I don't know what colour, but I'm going to lay down the green and then decide. Okay, so next we are going to use Warp Stone Glow. I'm going to put some of this in my wet palette with a little bit of water just to thin it down. And then I'm going to start painting the orbs. I do this in three stages. The first stage is to do a rough coat around the orb just to start to lay down the colour, because it takes several coats to build up the green to make it nice and punchy. The second coat I do a bit neater and just fill in all of the edges. And then the third coat I go over all of the green and just bring it up. Sometimes a fourth coat is needed, but usually three does the job. I do more coats on the very big orb on the top of the throne there. That takes about five or six coats actually, just to build up the colour and make it nice and smooth and bright. So yeah, do this all over the orbs that you want to paint green, and then we'll go on to the next stage. Okay, so next it's mute green. We are going to start painting over the green orbs just to build up a nice bright colour. Now the idea here is to leave the original warpstone colour around the edges so that you can still see it, and then use this mute green for the main sections of the orbs. Now I don't actually touch the lightning effect here, just doing the orbs. We'll come back to the lightning effect in a minute. Now again, this will take around 3 coats of paint just to build up a nice, smooth, even finish. There you go, you can see how all of those orbs are really popping amongst the silver and the black stone. Now, I didn't paint every single orb just because of how my colour scheme goes. You can paint as little or as many orbs as you like. I may go in and increase my number of orbs at the end, depending on how it looks when it's all put together. But for now, I'm happy with that. Now, I'm not sure how I'm going to actually paint the Catan himself yet. I haven't decided. I like the silver, but I've done a silver Catan before and I don't think it will stand out enough on this big centerpiece model. So I'm going to choose a different colour. I just haven't decided which one yet. Okay, so next we are going to paint the Silent King himself and the 2 bodyguards. Now at this stage I actually realised I didn't paint the black stone on the king's staff, so I've got to paint that. And also I don't really know how I'm going to paint the staff itself. However, I know how I'm going to paint the armour of these 3 guys, and it's going to be gold. Now I've got quite a unique way of painting my gold for my army, stemmed back from the original shining gold colour, which is no longer available. So if you want to find out more about how I actually paint my gold colour, I'll link you up to a video at the end of this video for you to watch next. But it's basically still dry brushing techniques. I dry brush various colours to finally give me my gold colour. Now I do try to go as carefully as I can when I'm dry brushing these miniatures because, well, maybe it's just me, but I find the new plastic is just not quite as good. On these push fit miniatures, the plastic just seems a lot more fragile. So I very carefully dry brush these miniatures until I've got the gold that I'm looking for. And here it is. And as you can see, even though I was very, very careful, well, the models are broken, so the Silent King actually broke at the waist, which I wasn't expecting, and some of the tabards came off as well. I was able to glue them back together, so it really wasn't a problem, but just try to be as careful as you can. Now don't be afraid to get some of your old miniatures out so you can compare the painting so that you can try to match things in. So I matched in my gold to this guy, and of course I'm looking at the staff and the cloak and other things as well to see how I'm going to paint the rest of these miniatures going forward. Okay, so back to the Catan, and I finally decided which colour I'm going to paint it in, and it's going to be purple. Thanks very much for all of the feedback on my membership community tab and Facebook page. That was a great help. Purple it is. It's a nice royal colour and it should complement the green very nicely to help make it pop. So I'm using Xerius Purple on my wet palette with some water, and then I'm going to base coat the whole of the Catan with this colour. I'm going to build up the colour with 2 or 3 coats, just allowing me to get a nice even coverage. Okay, once that's dried, we are going to go in with a purple wash, Druchy Violet. And this is going to give us some shadowing for all of the recesses. So I'm going to give the pot a good shake, open the lid. I'm going to use the top of a paintbrush just to hold the lid open. Very useful trick if you don't do that already. It really does help. And I'm going to go over all of the purple with this shade. Once done, I'm going to let it fully dry before I do the next stage. And for the next stage, we're going to use the base coat Xerius Purple and Gene Stealer Purple. I've got both of those colours on my wet palette, and then I've mixed them together so that I have a range of purple going from the base coat to a nice light purple. And then I'm going to start dry brushing. I'm using the new a synthetic dry brush from Games Workshop here because, well, I wanted to try it out. I haven't used one before, and apparently it's quite good for bringing out the edges. So I thought I'd have a go, and I have to say, after trying it, I really liked it. So I start off with the base coat and just dry brush all over. Then I start to go into the lighter purples, and I just basically dry brush all of the edges up. However, the lighter the purple got, the less dry brushing I did. And I tried to dry brush from the top downwards on those final highlights, just to make it look as if the light was coming from the top. Now, once I'd gone through those colours, I then got Slaanesh Grey out of the pot. And I put some of that on my wet palette, and then I mixed the previously light colour in with this one, just so that I had an even lighter purple. I also put just Slaanesh Grey on the wet palette as well to use at a later stage. Then I continued to dry brush, very, very light dry brushing. And again, each time the paint got lighter, the less area of dry brushing that I did. I just tried to bring out the extreme edges of this miniature. So I just gradually built up the highlights until I had a Catan that I was happy with. And of course, it was very easy to paint. Easy peasy, Catan squeezy. Okay, so we're continuing to dry brush here. First of all, I got my monolith door out because there's lightning on that and I wanted to duplicate the effect. So I'm using the traditional mute green first, and then I'm going to use another highlight with Nurgling Green. So I'm just turning my wet palette and tissue around here so I've got some fresh material. Then I'm going to start dry brushing. Now, first of all, I was going to dry brush with a small dry brush, but I decided I needed a bigger one on this section, so I got my big dry brush out, and then I just dry brushed the mute green over the edges of this lightning effect. I did get my little dry brush, and I dry brushed the insides of this area, but it was just quicker to use the big dry brush for the outside areas. Now, I did this on the bottom of the two side stones and, of course, on the Catan himself. Now, on the Catan, I tried to blend the lightning, the green lightning, into the Catan's purple. So I had like a nice mixture of colours blending in from one to the other. Again, just with dry brushing, but very simple to achieve. Once that was all done, I then used the Nurgling Green and I just gently dry brushed over the top of everything, slightly less than the previous dry brush, just so that I get a nice variety of greens within that lightning, just to make it pop. Okay, so now we are going to tidy up the metalwork where the green and some of the dry brushing has gone onto it. First of all, I'm just going to very gently paint over the little circles next to the orb. This is almost like a dry brush. I've got hardly any paint on, just to make those little circles silver. And then I went over all of the areas of the metal which had some green on just from some of the dry brushing I'd done. I just gently went over the top of it just to fill in the metal work. Now, there wasn't that much because I was pretty careful with my dry brushing. But basically, yeah, I just went over all of the silver and I just tidied up any areas that were messy. Then, continuing on with the silver, just to bring a little bit of contrast into it, I got my black paint out, put some water in it, and I'm going to paint some of the veins, what I call them, the veins. So on the legs and on the top section of the throne, there's these big, like, holes almost within the plates. So I just line in the paint. You could use a wash, but I find the black just gives me a little bit more depth and contrast. So I do this all over the legs. I don't do it on those big back sections, which I was pointing to earlier in the clip. And of course, I do that on the throne's top section as well, because there's some plates on there also with some deep recesses. So with the silver tidied up and the black in the recesses, the silver is all done. So now I decided I would glue the Catan onto the top section so I could really get a feel of how it's starting to look. Okay, so next it's the characters, and I really need to work out how I'm going to paint these because, to be honest, at this stage I didn't really know. I thought the best thing to do is start with the stuff that I know how it's going to be painted, and that's all of the orbs and the little symbols on the bodies. I'm going to match those little sections into how I normally paint my characters in the Necron army. So here they are with all of the green sections done, and now it's time for me to make some decisions. And I couldn't make a decision, so I thought about it a little bit longer, and instead I started work on the bases. So I rolled up some green stuff and I let it dry, and then I made some green stuff crystals. I've already got some rocks which I had left over from my previous Necron project. They go on the bases as well. So I just cut these crystals up. If you want a full tutorial on how to do this, not only with green stuff but with old sprue, then again there's a link to that video in the description below, so check it out. Okay, so time to do the purple, and I didn't want to do an opaque purple. I wanted something a little bit different, so I was thinking about how Tesseract Glow works, where you paint white and then you do the glow paint over the top. So I thought maybe I could do that with purple, so I experimented. I used some white in the recesses of this Tomb Blade section, and then I put the wash over the top, and it came out horrible. It just didn't look right. So I thought, how about I use Gene Stealer purple instead of the white? And I tried that, put the wash over the top, and I thought it looked really cool. So I've decided to paint the staff and also the shaft of the staff in this colour. And then I'm going to do the same on the cloak. And then I'll do the tabards on the characters with an opaque purple all highlighted up. So that is what I went about doing. So with some watered down Gene Stealer, I started edge highlighting the blade of the Silent King. I also went into all of the recesses around that blade and in the recesses around the shaft of the staff as well. I then did the same for the cloak, so I went to all the raised little squares and also the recessed little squares, and I put the Gene Stealer purple in all of those little sections, ready for the wash. I also painted the tabards with that Gene Stealer purple as well, so now I'm ready to wash everything. So I got my Druchi Violet wash and started washing. Now once again, it's key that you complete one section before the wash dries in one foul swoop. So I decided to paint the back of the cloak first, and then to paint the other side once it dried. Now the other key thing here, of course, is to make sure that you get no pooling from the wash. So I was pretty careful just spreading this wash out. So I did this all over that side of the cloak when it was dried. Then I did the other side. I gave all of the tabards obviously a wash of this as well, and then when that was dry, I dry brushed it with Gene Stealer purple, and then I dry brushed it with a bit of Slaanesh purple mixed into the Gene Stealer purple. And then it came to the staff, so again I just put this wash over the staff. I knew when it dried it would dry much thinner, so you'd still have the metal coming through. And then with the highlights that are already done of Gene Stealer purple in the recesses and on the edges would just give me that really cool effect. I also put this on the staff shaft at the same time. And there is all the purple done and dried, and I'm really happy how it's looking. I've got that purple fill to match the Catan at the top, but without making the purple colour too overpowering. And obviously you could use these techniques but with an alternative colour to match whatever paint scheme you're using. I then got the green stuff crystals and I super glued them onto the base. I actually put the bottom half of the throne into position so I knew where the crystals were going to go. And my plan will be to add some rocks to the base as well as these crystals, just to give it a little bit more depth. Okay, so with the bodyguards in place, I could really look at the model and how it's looking and work out what colour I want those symbols on the front, and I did decide that I would go for gold. I also looked at the steps and decided that when they're all in place, they were a bit plain. So I painted the little orbs in the centre of the steps. I didn't do all of the orbs. I thought it would be a bit overpowering. So I just did the middle ones. So with the crystals all dried, I put on some sand with PVA, let that dry, and then I painted everything with black. This is a watered down black, and I actually did two coats, letting it dry thoroughly before going on to the next stage. Once dried, I then painted the crystals with Caliban Green. I then dry brushed them with Warpstone Glow, and then I dry brushed them again with Mute Green. And then I dry brushed the black sand with Dawnstone Grey, just to finish it off, and stuck on all of the rocks which I'd previously made onto the base with some super glue. And then when that was dry, all I had to do was paint the rims of the bases with black. And that is my Silent King all painted. Pretty quick, pretty easy to do, but I think looks super cool. But what do you think? Let me know in the comments box below. I really hope the video was useful to you. And as I said, there's lots of links to all of my other tutorials in the description below. And here is the video I was talking about, where you can learn how to paint my gold.